Games 2 and 3 between the Flyers and Pens were truly a tale of two cities and an illustration of the fine line between winning and losing in the spring. Game 2 swung on just two or three plays, where inches literally made the difference. The Penguins found a way to make enough plays to secure victory and a 2-0 series lead. Philadelphia frustration was evident. But Game 3 brought the series across state to the frenzied Wachovia Center. It was not a game for the meek. But the Flyers got off the deck and pushed back, determined to make their own breaks this time around. Eventually, their will was rewarded with a barrage of goals. Now they stand one win from evening this best-of-7 game series. Game 4 is next. Players from both locker rooms are fully engaged in this series now. Some have already experienced the ups and downs that come with the Stanley Cup playoffs. The question tonight, who will be the hero as Game 4 takes place inside the walls of the Wachovia Center? One thing we can count on, a lot of noise. The fans get prepared for this one with a block party outside. And then eventually they'll make their way inside the Wachovia Center. And it will be a raucous building as it was for Game 3. The Flyers and Penguins set to have at it again here tonight. And a pleasant good evening. Welcome to Flyers playoff coverage here on Comcast Sportsnet. Along with Bill Clement, I'm Jim Jackson. Steve Coates will join us here in just a moment. Bill, I know it's only one game here tonight, but the difference between being down 1-3 in a series and being even 2-2 is immense.
Yeah, it's a big difference. But we know that the blood feud will continue one way or the other. Anybody that watched Game 3 knows that the crowd here at the Wachovia Center, I think, had an influence on the outcome, and I expect the Pittsburgh Penguins to come with a huge push here in Game 4 to try to force the Flyers to the brink of elimination. The crowd will have to do their part again, which I think they will. The Flyers have to match the desperation level that they showed in Game 3.
We like to get caught up in numbers, of course. You look at the numbers for Flyers captain Mike Richards in this series, a goal and an assist, nothing special, but there's so much more to his game.
I can't tell you how much there is to his game. A lot of players can end up on the score sheet and play a quiet brand of hockey. There is nothing quiet about Mike Richards' game. You notice him every shift on the ice, and he has been given every opportunity to make as much noise as he wants because he leads all forwards in ice time in the playoffs. I think of Mike Richards as the Flyers' Swiss Army knife. Doesn't matter how tough the job is, doesn't matter what the job is, he'll find a tool in his bag of tools to get the job done. So it doesn't matter how tough the top of that can is, he'll find the can opener to get a rip off.
Indeed he will. As important as Richards and Carter and their lines are to the Flyers, after Game 1, Bill, we knew the Flyers would have to have other players step up because we saw Pittsburgh's depth up front. Well, some young guys have done just that.
Yeah, without a doubt. We know the Flyers' 6-25 goal scorers are going to do what they do best this time of year, but to get help from third and fourth liners really helped the Flyers, and they continue to help as the series moves along. Claude Giroux, Darryl Powell, and Jared Ross. Jared Ross is centering the fourth line for the Flyers. Smallest guy in the lineup for Philadelphia, but he notched his first NHL goal. Forget about first playoff goal, first NHL goal in Game 3. Darryl Powell has simply gotten better. Every week he has played for the Flyers, he has been in Sidney Crosby's face, anybody wearing a Penguins uniform, and yes, he scored his first playoff goal in Game 2. But the big story for me is Claude Giroux. You had to ask yourself at the end of Game 2, as a rookie, was he in over his head? He was in the penalty box when the game was lost. Well, he answered that question in Game 3, and the answer is a resounding forget about it. He is so ready for prime time, picked up a goal and an assist. So the Flyers not only have their big guns to look to, they now have support scoring to help out in the process.
Well, we may have wondered whether Claude Giroux would bounce back from Game 2. We wondered if Kimmo Tiemann would get up in Game 3 after that big hit he took, Coatsy. Not only did he get up, he went on to play a tremendous hockey game.
You know, Jimmy, in the playoffs, it's that time of year where you target certain players to get them off their game. Well, obviously, those certain players are the best players on the individual teams. And when you talk about Kimmo Tiiminen, you're talking about the best defenseman on the Philadelphia Flyers. The Barry Ashby winner has the best defenseman. But that's the hit he took from Kunitz, and he didn't even blink. He got right back up. He does so many things for the Flyers. He's so good. He's so smart in his own zone. He's great with the first pass to get that puck out of the zone. He's outstanding on the power play, manning that blue line, and he's so quick with the sticks. That's why the Philadelphia Flyers have seen that Tiiminen has been a target of the Pittsburgh Penguins throughout this series. Now, we take a look at the culprits for the Penguins. Kunitz especially. Oh, yeah, he's only got one assist out of Ferris State, believe it or not. Acquired from the Ducks during the regular season for Ryan Whitney, and you can see that the numbers for Brooke Shorpik and what he's done as far as taking the body. 19 hits in this series, 6'2", 228 pounds, and all he does is wait for you to have your head down. Chris Kunitz, oh, yeah, he's only 5'11", 185 pounds, but he acts like a human bowling ball out there. He just runs into everything, north, south, up and down. And the bottom line, guys, is that the Philadelphia Flyers need to match that physical play of the Pittsburgh Penguins like they did in Game 3.
No doubt about that, Coatsy. Another challenge for this team dealing with Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin. And Bill, the scary thing is, while their numbers are good, I don't think they've actually been all that dominant in this series.
No, I don't think they have either. And it's tough to think of as a Penguin, as a monster. But this is a two-headed monster. Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin, as Coatsy said, they have to be the targets of the Flyers' physical play.
The Penguins look to grab a stranglehold of the series. The Flyers hope to get even. Game 4 is straight ahead.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on Comcast SportsNet are brought to you by Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. By Toyota, a smart way to keep moving forward. And by Bud Light. The difference is drinkability. Philadelphia sports fans showed their true mettle over the weekend, where they were showing their love to the beloved Harry Callis by turning out in the thousands for his memorial service on Saturday, or by supporting the Flyers with their unbridled enthusiasm as part of the electric Stanley Cup playoff atmosphere on Sunday. Philadelphia sports fans' passion unmatched. Plenty of it in evidence at the block party, and we'll get another dose of that passion as the decibel level rises with puck drop in Game 4 after these messages. Game 4 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals is brought to you by Honda. Test drive a 2009 Honda today at your Honda dealer. And by Mountain Dew. Do the do. Charged up. God bless America. Lauren Hart, Kate Smith teaming up. And this place is electric. Wachovia set already for Game 4 of this Eastern Conference quarterfinal series between the Flyers and Pens. Flyers do not want to fall behind 3-1 in the series. They have never won when doing so. So it's all there in front of them here tonight.
And the longer a series goes, the more important the performances of the men in the suits of armor. Marty Biron for the Flyers again in goal. Marc-Andre Fleury for the Penguins, no change.
Underway in Game 4, Flyers wearing their orange tops. Road whites for the Penguins. Sergei Gonchar sending the puck up to the center. The Penguins sending Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin out to start this hockey game. Dan Bowser decides to load the deck here for the start. Simone Gagné moving up for Philadelphia. The play is onside as he dishes in. The fire line combinations, the defense pairs at the bottom of your screen. No changes for Philadelphia. From Game 3, Richards wrestle off the puck but dives to poke it back toward Tiiminen, but it drifts past him and Ryan Parrott has to go back to three for Philadelphia.
Sidney Crosby had to flex his defensive muscles. Mike Richards on a good play trying to step out from behind the net.
You know Tiiminen off that tremendous performance in Game 3 ahead. Pittsburgh Penguins combinations at the bottom of your screen. No changes for the Penguins either. Same players that took the ice in game three for both clubs. A foul for Andrew Alberts. Down low, Briere. Briere looking for Giroux, is tipped away. Powell recaptures. Back to the point. Jones, a shot, and that's taken in the midsection by Fleury. And he will pin it against his body.
Give us a chance to look at our keys to the game. Number one for the Flyers, stay out of the sin bin. The Penguins already have four power play goals, and they've had 20 opportunities. Crowd Fleury, not only to take his vision away, but it's a good place to do some rebound hunting. Own the neutral. The neutral zone is the speed zone. That is oxygen for Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin.
In general, Bill, you think the Flyers have done a pretty good job in the neutral zone this series?
They really have. The Penguins have not established their rush game.
There's a quick shot by Powell. The save made by Fleury. He'll cover. Then Powell wrestled to the ice by Hal Gill. Powell very energized in this series. As you look at our virtuous scratches from the lineups, again, the same as for game three. Espiza is a healthy scratch for Philadelphia. Everybody but Zygmantas, a healthy scratch for Pittsburgh.
Well, right now, Sidney Crosby really hasn't been that evident as much as you would think in this series, but actually he's tied the record right now for most consecutive points going back to last year's Stanley Cup Finals, guys. And that just is a matter of Sidney Crosby being an outstanding hockey player.
Flyers moving in. Cutter shot off the crossbar. Jeff Cutter that close to getting the Flyers off to a rousing start. The other way go the Penguins. Guerin for Kunitz. This Kunitz pass back. Montchar able to handle it. He'll dish to Mark Eaton. Getting it along the wall. Eluded Hartnell. Crosby's there. Centering pass gobbled up by Hartnell. He'll try the board, but right there is Gonchar. He'll wind up in fire, blocked off by Tiedemann. Tiedemann checked as he goes to the wall, and then he ends up knocking down Crosby. The crowd loves that. And the Flyers move back with the puck. Here's Joffrey Lupul. Lupul went across ice. Carter off the carom. Around behind. Jeff Carter back out to Matt Carl. Carl will send it in along the boards. Just beyond Hartnell's reach, he's going to try to track it down the other side, but getting there first, Kunitz ahead for Malkin. Nice little sweep check there by Coburn. Carl up on the play and center, bounces back to Coburn, and he'll fire in off the stick of Malkin. Great pace early, as expected. Malkin given some rough treatment by Knubel. The pass for Fedotenko. Richards sweeps it away from him. Knubel to it. Gonchar marking him. Gagne is there. To Richards, quick shot. This is the target and sails to the boards. Matt Carl in. Carl taken to the wall by Sikora. Gagne frees it up for Richards. Got it out in front. Fleury had to make the save and cover. Outstanding job by the Flyers here early. They've spent a lot of time in the offensive zone.
But they're getting the pucks in quickly, and they're getting him into soft spots. Mike Knubel had a great forecheck going. He got supported by Simon Gagne. And once Mike Richards got involved, they were able to step out in front. Jeff Carter's line. This close to being on the board. Clink.
You know what, Billy? This has been such a key. If they get that second guy in on this group of defense, they can make things happen, as they made that happen in game two. Great feed, right? By the mistakes that the defense of the Pittsburgh Penguins made. Just get after them.
And Asham's shot deflects and caught the safety netting, and play is stopped. Another face off to the right of Marc-Andre Fleury.
Yeah, Coach, he brings up a good point. It's easy to play this game if you don't have a 215-pound guy breathing down your back trying to make you part of the ads on the boards. And when the Flyers forecheck and bring it the way they have so far in this game, they can force turnovers.
And Albert's shot drifted wide of a huge crowd in front of Fleury. The Flyers have Carcillo, Ross, and Asham out on the ice. Carcillo may have been clipped.
Andrew Albert's shot from the blue line hit somebody and went up high, and then Chris Letang got his stick up on Dan Carcillo.
It's that price you pay for being in front. Puck whizzes by your chin, and then a stick gets you when you turn around. Race for the puck here. Pascal Dupuis and Albert. Albert's won the race. The puck ahead to Asham. Hesitated, and he's bumped by Crosby. Now Albert's working on Dupuis. Asham back. Nice play ahead to Ross. His first goal of any kind in the NHL in game three, and said his father called it. His father told him before the game he's going to score a goal, save the puck. He wanted the puck, his dad did. So you make a prediction like that, you get the puck. Carcillo bumped. Letang with good work there. Head to Craig Adams.
member of the Carolina Stanley Cup winning team back at 06. Dumps the puck into the Philadelphia zone. Off the bench in Briere. He'll get it out in center ice. Giroux dancing up with it. Claude Giroux, nifty maneuvering, then tried to flip one deep. It went off of Vorpik around behind the net. Asham after it there. Gonchar and he wrestled. Tyler Kennedy will toss it back around for Brooks Vorpik. Flyers have the first three shots on goal in this game. As we approach the 4-minute mark of period number one. Stahl to the puck. Kennedy to Stahl. An angle shot stopped by the stick of Garazzi. Laid the paddle down. Here the other way. He'll pump one in. A bouncer that Fleury will play at the side of the net. And he decides to cover again. Flyers getting right in on him. And they'll take the offensive draw. Offensive zone draw, at least.
Love the decisions the Flyers are making. Every puck has gone in deep. And that sets up a game for a guy like Darryl Powell, the straight line player. Great speed. He finishes everybody when he gets in on the forecheck. So when Darryl Powell is first man in, what either Claude Giroux or Danny Briere want to do, and John Stevens has told them this, it's 101 in hockey, get there for support, because there will be loose pucks after Darryl Powell does his job.
Now the Richards line out for Philadelphia. Lubo and Richards will work along the boards. Richards all the way out to Gagne. Gagne dishes Carl. Shot! Save Fleury. Knubel trying to get his stick in there, but Fleury, it'll make the glove stop.
Remember in game one how the Flyers had to survive that first 10 minutes of fury from the Pittsburgh Penguins? It's exactly the other way around here. Flyers are quicker, stronger. Look at that. That faceoff was lost, and the Flyers still got it.
And the big thing right now is that they're beating them everywhere. Beating them on the faceoffs, they're beating them in the corner. They're taking the body. They're getting the better of this hockey club right now by just effort. They came out in typical Philadelphia Flyers fashion, have dominated here in the early going by going right after Pittsburgh at every part of that hockey, at the end of the ice, rather.
You want a number that says it all. This is the seventh offensive zone faceoff of this game.
Less than 4.5 minutes into the game. That does tell all. Here's Al Gill. Ahead. Ruslan Fedotenko. Avoids a check attempt from Richards. Knubel. Oh, will finish him off in the corner. Jones, or Coburn turned around. Tipped the puck to the corner. Now Fedotenko after it. It's Knubel. Ahead to Gagne. Simone Gagne will dish in the left wing, but Malkin is there. Getting Malkin the long pass back to Fedotenko. He'll wind up and fire. And it went off the glove of Veron and then the outside of the net. And Marty decides to cover at the side of the cage.
A scary moment for the fans behind Marty Biron that saw puck against twine. Luckily, it was on the outside of the twine. To be so careful when Malkin turns like that, because he's always looking up ice for somebody. That time he found Fedotenko. But a net cam look at it. Just enough of it. Actually, when it goes 10 inches outside the post, it's a significant miss. That's a good save.
He's got a piece of Miron's luck before catching outside. That is a point shot block. And then it's Carter picking the puck up and steamrolling ahead. The right wing feed to Lupo. Winds and blasts. And that one deflects. Goes into the safety netting. And out of play. Ready, set, grow. Show your Flyers spirit by growing one for the team. The Flyers Beardathon is on. Grow your beard and invite your friends, family, and coworkers to pledge money for your playoff beard. If you can't grow a beard, support your favorite Flyers players as they grow theirs. All proceeds benefit Flyers charities.
Yeah. Coatsy. What happened was that they think I look like a fisherman now with this beard. So I thought I'd play the part.
Coatsy, I can't really disagree with that assessment. Flyers. A point shot here, but Parent fans on it. As Fleury got caught out of the net and then lost his stick, just getting the stick back as the puck is floating in on him. He gloves the disc down and tosses it to Orpik. Head for Guerin, and now the cross-ice pass. Andre Gonchar gains the line and waits and then flips, and that's snared by Miron. Too much traffic around him to put the puck in play, so he'll hang right on to it.
No real test for Marty Biron yet. But I always like the fact that he gets his glove established when he gets it going. He seems to really be able to feel it. A lot of teams have tried to beat Marty Biron to the glove, and most have failed.
There's a good save for Biron off a deflection of that point shot. Tyler Kennedy gets to the puck. Kennedy out to Eaton. Across it goes. Letang finding it deep. Kennedy had it hop over his stick, and then he's punished by Giroux. Now the battle ensues. Four players. Alberts is in there. Kennedy. Matt Cook hoping the puck pops free. This is hard work along the boards, and it's Penguins will win this one. Cook back to Eaton, and now Cook. Turnaround shot, blocked to the corner. Briere is back, looking for Alberts. He'll just keep Staal away from it, but over is Cook. Round behind Kennedy. Kennedy holding on, by the center. That one stopped at the side of the net, but back to Kennedy in the corner. Harassed by Alberts. Tyler Kennedy out to Letang, dishes to Eaton. Eaton will turn in a wrist shot. That was a save by Veron, perhaps off a deflection, and now a penalty. Alberts took down Kennedy, and the Flyers will be penalized. The Penguins will get the game's first power play, and we'll have it for you when we come back.
This is a big matchup we've been watching in this series, the third line against the third line. This time, Jordan Staal along with Kennedy and Cook are doing a great job penetrating the zone. And right here you see Alberts pull down Kennedy with the opportunity to the right of Biron. So the first power play of tonight's hockey game goes to the Pittsburgh Penguins.
21st of the series, the Flyers have had 14. Flyers get to a loose puck. Carter to Hartnell. Hartnell across the line for Carter. Tipped it in. Fleury had to get the pad up. Carter is hurt as he was decked into the boards. Penalty on Pittsburgh. Their power play is short-lived. Dennis LaRue makes the call. Kevin Pollock, by the way, the other referee, and wincing in pain is Carter as he makes his way back toward the Philadelphia bench.
Jeff Carter would have had every right to just stay in the corner in a heap. This is so fortunate that Jeff Carter got up from this. Watch how hard he hits the boards. Can't see it from that angle. Oh, my gracious. Going full speed. What saves Jeff Carter here? He hits the boards evenly with all parts of his body at the same time. Didn't go head first, shoulder first, knee first. So the impact was really spread out.
Boy, do I agree with that, because he actually went in sideways, like you said, Billy. If he goes head first, you got a problem. If he goes shoulder first or puts his hands out, you're looking at yourself as a separated shoulder. So very fortunate there.
4-on-4 hockey. As a result, the Flyers go to work. Mike Richards, listing in the corner. It's checked by Fortnite, even if it snuck down low, so no one at the point. Matty Jones back to get it for Philadelphia. So the Pittsburgh power play lasted all of 8 seconds. Flyers will get an 8-second power play at the end of the 4-on-4 situation. Jones played it right into Malkin, got away with it. Now the pass ahead for Gagne. Sends it deep to Pittsburgh ice. Gagne tips to Richards. Richards in the middle. Jones shot blocked off by Crosby. Crosby's been blocking a lot of shots in this series. He's just dumping that one in the corner. Penguins after it. Malkin tied up by Carl. Got it to the point. Gagne kept it in. Plays it around Malkin, who hooked him. Penalty. Cross ice pass. Coburn shot. Fleury the save. Malkin penalized. The Flyers to get a 4-on-3 advantage.
It's a really good call, and it was created by an incredible move by Simon Gagne. He looked across the blue line and dropped his shoulder, and Evgeny Malkin took the bait. The barb was set in his lip, and he ended up hooking Simon Gagne because of the great move.
So 58 seconds remain on the Alberts penalty. It's 4-on-3 until that penalty runs its course, and then a brief 5-on-3, but the Flyers try to score with a mad advantage here. Teaming in, great pass down low, the shot, Richards and Fleury able to make the save. Briere out to Teaming in. Got Briere, Carter, and Richards out for Philadelphia with Teaming in. Here's Richards, one time blast off the shoulder of Fleury. Carter kept the rebound alive, but Cook is there to bank it out of the zone.
Right now, Marc-Andre Fleury is the only reason the Flyers haven't scored.
Flyers power play is tallied at each game. Here is Thiemann holding on. Briere, Carter is in front. Briere fakes the shot, then the pass to Carter across crease, and that one tipped away. Inches away from being a great tic-tac-toe play, but it was knocked down. Now Richards tried to whip that one in front. That's knocked down by Scuderi and cleared all the way down by Staal.
One shot by Richards where he was one-on-one. Just him and Fleury. The puck bounced on him right at the last second.
Flyers had a brief 5-on-3, but that is over now as Letang is out of the box. So now it's a 5-on-4, 50 seconds remaining on the Malkin penalty. That pass tipped away. Gagne trying to get it back. Letang will send it around the boards and glass. Thiemann will take the hit from Talbot. And the puck then tipped by Gagne to Carter. Carter out to Thiemann.
on the boards. Ribriere. All the way across. Richard shot. Deflected and bounced across through the glass. Talbot is there. He'll try the other side. Waiting for it is Richards. Send it toward the middle. All white jerseys. Talbot to Craig Adams. And he'll shovel one out of the zone and down the ice. 16 seconds is all that remains in the power play. Flyers have time to begin one more. An advantage rush. Demon in. A long pass. Gill was ready for that. He looks to start the Penguins back. He'll lumber in across the line. Hits Teeman with his dumping, and it bounces all the way out. There's Scott Hartnell, but he's one on three. He turns back, coming late. There's Giroux with the pass, the shot, and the save, Fleury. And he's somehow able to control the puck, and then the pushing and shoving begins. But Marc-Andre Fleury has been tremendous here early.
Boy, when the Flyers have been able to button hook and curl it back just inside the blue line and wait for somebody coming late, here's what Scott Hartnell did. The Penguins, no coverage at all. Claude Giroux with a good chance, and then Joffrey Lupul got caught in the spin cycle.
And this save is unbelievable on Giroux, because you got Fleury going from right to left, and he got it with his right pad right at the last minute. Or his motion would have taken him right by. If Giroux had just held on just a little bit, he would have had a wide open net, guys.
They rule the puck came out to center there moments ago, so this faceoff will be in the neutral zone. Just about halfway through this first period. Glad you could join us on Comcast Sportsnet. Just more of the same here thus far. Absolutely outstanding. Hot and intense. No score. 8-5 the shots in favor of Philadelphia.
And 10-4 the scoring chances in favor of the Flyers.
Harry Guerin trying to center. That's blocked off by Carl, who then pokes the puck free. The Flyers pick it up, and Claude Giroux starts up. His pass right on the tape to Lupul. There's Giroux getting a shift here with Lupul and Hartnell. Puck into the corner. Lupul in front. Here's Giroux out of his skates. And then his backhand attempt cut off by Letang. Spun it back through the slot. Coburn in after. He'll drop to Lupul. Lupul has a look and takes the shot. That's blocked by Kunitz. 3-on-3 back the other way for the Penguins. Here's Guerin picking it up. He'll wind and fire. Pad save here on. Then it's swept out to center by Coburn. Hartnell wiping out in center. The Flyers get back to the puck. Here's Carl ahead to Hartnell. And all the way down it goes.
That shot by Guerin had knuckleball movement but fastball speed.
It was a tricky one, and Biron got the pad on it. Eaton brings it in. He's going to follow his own dumping toward Barry behind the Philadelphia net. Powell there. The puck ricocheting back to Sikora. His pass blocked off by Parent. But picked up by the Penguins and sent to Malkin. Malkin in the corner. Demonen trying to stay with him. He got it to Fedotenko. Fedotenko stumbles, kicked it out of his skates, went right into the slot to Sikora for a shot. It chipped up high and then was knocked down. Bounces all the way out to Carcillo. He'll go the other way with it. Carcillo pumps it into the Pittsburgh zone. Powell or Carcillo trying to get it back across behind the net, but it got caught up in that maze of bodies. Albert's a wrister, and that one just went wide as Fleury was late in reacting. They have changed direction. Here's Sikora. Sikora pumped by Ashton. Fedotenko shot. Save. Vera rebound off of him. He dives back. And he's got it underneath him. No goal is the call. It was crawling toward the line, but Vera able to cover. Still no score.
Anxious moment for the Flyers, but I'm surprised there wasn't more noise from the bench, because Evgeny Malkin of the Penguins cross-checked Marty Biron. Hit him in the helmet. Look at the arms extended by Evgeny Malkin. There was no call on the play. Kind of what happened to Scott Hartnell in game one, except Malkin wasn't even pushed.
I think everybody was looking to see if that puck was going to go in the net. Marty did a great job of turning and making sure, even after it went off his helmet, to make sure it didn't cross the line. I think because of that, they didn't see how Malkin did come in, obviously with a cross check.
Yeah, that would have been a call that probably would have had to be made by the referee out high, because there's no question the referee down low has to be watching the puck there to see if it gets across the line. Good point, Coach. Referee down near the line didn't see it.
A lot of bodies between the referee out high and the front of the net.
All worked out for the Penguins. Is there still an even strength? And doing some work down low in the Philadelphia zone. Here's Letang. Dishing to Cook. Cross ice right off the skate. Of Randy Jones ahead to Powell. And they'll clear it to center ice. The Penguins get it right back. Cook for Stahl. And into the Philadelphia zone he goes. Powell trying to fight off Stahl. And he did. He got it to Jones. Jones along the wall for Briere. His pass to Giroux. He hangs on and then floats one in that Fleury will hang on to. Wow. He had a lot of time to do something with that, but I wasn't sure that he knew exactly where that puck was in his glove, so ends up
getting the faceoff.
Don't just watch the Flyers game. Chat online during the game, too. Flyers analyst Al Morgani is chatting online right now. Log on to CSNPhilly.com now. Chat online with Al and other Flyers fans. Keyword, Flyers chat.
Dear Al, I remember when your hair looked like Eddie Munster.
Oh, that's not right.
Why? It was a good look for Al. Love you, Al.
He's going to get listening. A ton of them now. You know he's going to get a ton of entries about that now.
His hair's better now?
No, it's good anytime.
You know a little about that, Coatsy.
There's Malkin, penalty. And I think Malkin's going to get one here. No, is it holding on Parent?
Ah. This call made by Kevin Pollock. Parent is in disbelief at this point. No. Oh, it's going to be Parent alone.
Look, Kevin Pollock went right by me. He was standing right at the dot when he made the call. And he's going to say that Parent actually called or pulled Malkin down as we take a look at the corner, Billy.
Well, you see what Malkin did first. He tried to ride Parent off the play before either of them got to the puck. See what Malkin did right here? That's what I thought was getting called. If anything, they both should have gone, because once Ryan Parent found himself in no man's land, he grabbed on. But Malkin created it.
Officials need to know that Evgeny Malkin can go to the penalty box in this game. Here's Chris Letang.
It's in his contract.
That he can go over there. Yeah. Crosby didn't know about it. Crosby. Holding on. Big moment here as the Flyers try to fight off this Pittsburgh power play. Great pass to Gonchar. His shot blocked by Gagne. Letang. For Crosby, teaming and got in the way. Coburn stuffs it around the other way, but Gonchar will race in to get to it. Bodied by Gagne. Kunitz picks it up. Across Letang. Skated in along the board, looking to the middle. And then back out for Gonchar. 40 seconds into the power play. Malkin for Gonchar. He leads him out to center ice. Quickly back to it, Letang for Malkin. Left to just re-enter the zone in a hurry. Look to that slot area, which is where they create a lot of their offense with those quick passes. But Demon was ready for that one. He knocked down Crosby's offer. Malkin has it back. Evgeny Malkin turns. Dishes Kunitz. Back for Malkin. Shot blocked by Demon and shovels it all the way down.
You just can't measure the amount of brain power Timo Teeminen has every shift.
42 seconds remain in the power play. Flyers have changed up to keep fresh legs out on the ice. Andrew Alberts got to that puck, but then the clear by Hartman was blocked. Garrett centers for Stahl. Loose puck. Two saves. Finally, Sikora shot, and it stayed out. Sikora from the doorstep must have hit the post as Jones then scoops it to center ice. I mean, Sikora had an empty net yawning at him. He was at a severe angle, but he believed that the puck was going in, but it never made it into the net. Here's Eaton. The stall stopped by Alberts. Puck tipped by Giroux with a high stick. So a faceoff in the Philadelphia zone. 6 seconds remaining on the power play.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Before Sikora's scoring opportunity, Marty Birol did a magnificent job of making sure his left pad didn't leave the post. Once he came back to it, then Sikora shot. But Marty Birol moved his pad about 4 inches back towards the post right there to make an outstanding save, and then Randy Jones almost put that in.
It was going wide. It hit Jones. It may have even hit the post off of Jones, but it stayed out. Wow. Running with it is Kennedy here. Now a backhand shot actually hit Maxime Talbot. Flyers back to full strength. Garrett is out of the box. Demon in check, could not get the puck past Kennedy. His shot fought off by Miron. Darryl Powell to the Carriman to move up with it. Power that great straight ahead speed, and he'll backhand into the Pittsburgh zone.
That was Marty's announcement that he has a telescopic leg, too.
There you go. And it's a strong
telescopic. Yes, it is.
Kennedy holding, and his shot deflected. Sails up into the safety netting, and play is stopped. 5:10 remaining first period. Lots of action. No scoring.
Well, we got lots of combinations here as far as saves here is concerned. The first one you're going to see here on Jordan Stahl, he's just going to backhand it. But look at this one by Sikora, Billy.
Went off crossbar, off Randy Jones, off the post, and out. Do not try this at home. You'll hurt yourself.
Never had a chance.
Does everybody get credit for a save there?
Oh, that is. I mean, you talk about the bounces. We saw so many of them
in game one and two. Mike Richards That's hitting the post so much there in game one. And of course, the tying goal in game two. Rick Schaff, shin pad. Sometimes they determine who wins, loses the game.
I watched Peter Sikora in the warm-up. I think there's something wrong with his left hand or his left wrist. He's hardly shot the puck in this series at all.
Penguins centering. Here's Dupuy chipping for Kunitz. Well behind him, and the Flyers will move up. Simone Gagné from the red line. The Flyers trying to get their momentum back. They were playing so well, but spending time down a man. And the Penguins now have been forcing things in the Flyers zone here of late. As Gill will float this one to the right of Biron. Sending it on the wall, but Crosby's waiting for it. Quick shot, save. Biron rebound to Dupuy, and he's quickly checked. The Flyers got to him in a hurry, and Parent backed him away from the disc. Now Ryan, Chemo teaming it. Pass ahead for Richards, gets the legs moving. Swinging wide to the left wing, centering, hoping for Knubel to run on through. Not getting to it. And now Richards. Richards had the puck roll. He'll tuck it back down low over Gagné's stick. Knubel into the corner. Knubel. Turning as they cycle it to Gagné. Across it goes. Back out for Carl. Carl to Carter, who placed Richards on the ice. The pass to Knubel. Knubel hidden by Malkin. To Gagné. Out to Coburn. Coburn, a shot deflected, but it went off glass. Carter got his stick on it, but it found glass. Good battle won there by Knubel. And then he's checked from behind by Malkin, and the puck to Dupuy. Dupuy for Malkin. So dangerous on the rush. His pass into the middle for Dupuy. Knocked aside by Coburn. Quick pass in the middle. Carl jumps on it. Matt Carl picking up speed through center. The right wing feed. Trying to get it to Carter. He one-hands it in on a flurry. Makes the save and covers in front of Hartnell. Flyers inches away from a good-looking rush right there. Well, we want to hear from you and who you think is the Verizon Wireless Star of the Game. Just grab your mobile phone and text the word star to 53695. 53695 for your vote. Standard charges apply. Or you can also go to csnphilly.com.
Scoring chances now 10-10 as the Penguins have come on and picked up the last five.
3:34 remaining in this period. It has been a period. Yes, the teams are scoreless, but they had their opportunities. And here's Kennedy. Picking up a loose puck, holds on, his shot blocked off by Alberts. Alberts poking that puck away before Kennedy could make any contact with it. On the other way, Powell trying to catch up to the penalty upcoming on the Penguins. Orpik steps in to Powell to end his bid, but there is a hooking minor, and the Flyers will go to the power play.
Pittsburgh number 24, 2 minutes hooking.
That would be Matt Cook, and this is an opportunity for the Flyers to take the lead in this game right near the end of the first period. The victim was Darryl Powell.
He continues to put his imprint on this
series. No question. He contributes so many ways.
Flyers get control. Richards shot. Rooted flurry, but went wide. There. Get to that airborne disc. Demon back for Briere. Twisted it behind that. Scuderi is there. Richards creams him. Mike Richards caught Scuderi with his head down and creamed him into the board.
That reminds you of Tom Pody at all?
Absolutely, yep.
That same type of hit. Head down, trying to get the puck out. And Richards just absolutely read it.
Guys move up. Knubel shot from the angle. He's tipped away and it hopped over Gagné's stick. And the Penguins move back 2-on-2. Stall. And Craig Adams, Stahl swinging wide, the shot, taken up high by Biron. And he'll hang on long enough. Nope, now he'll move the puck behind the net, and no whistle. As the referee gave Marty time to find that puck in his equipment. 1:10 remaining on the power play, 2:17 here in the period. Niemann drills it in. Carter gets it back in front. Hartnell shot, Fleury save, rebound, Carter! Save, Fleury again, another rebound, it's loose, Carter after it. But it tips through to Niemann. Flurry has been so good here in period number one. Demonin, Lupo on the wall. There's four players in there. Talbot. Now Hartnell joins in. Puck comes free right to Dupuy. Coburn is back. Dupuy turning on the speed, and they say it's outside as Talbot joins the rush. Biron gloves the puck. Comes together with Talbot. Flyers don't like when their goaltender
gets any kind of contact, so they arrive in ill humor.
Even when their goaltender comes out and creates the contact, right?
Absolutely. They didn't see that.
Right. You didn't either, apparently.
That's their story, and they're sticking to it. Well, the Flyers are hungry for more playoffs. Be sure to reserve your tickets for this Saturday, 3 o'clock. Penguins, Flyers. Game 6 at the Wachovia Center. Call 215-218-PUCK or visit the Flyers website to reserve your seats.
Well, on this power play, Mike Richards opened the door to the tattoo parlor and said, come on in, Rob Scuderi. It's going to hurt a little bit, and it's going to leave a mark.
The hitting has been hellacious in this series. Not that it's unexpected. And look, here are 10 hits. And again, here at the Wachovia Center, you have to earn your hits. In Pittsburgh, we get some hits for rubouts and so forth. The Bruins are up again 14 credited to him in game 2. Probably here it would have been 7 or 8. Just the difference in the way the official scorers see it.
How many did he get in game 3?
0.
None.
Moving on in, Giroux. Drop pass for Lupo, and it was tipped away at the last moment by Gonchar. Crosby to Malkin. Good play coming over Richards to knock it away. Play is offside at the Philadelphia line. So loud in here, you don't hear the whistles, but that one was offside and a faceoff in the neutral zone.
Dan Bylsma loading up his big guns, Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin on the same line, and the Flyers again taking away the speed in the neutral zone. Beautiful drop pass from Claude Giroux to Joffrey Lupul. Look at the Flyers recover. Try to cut the ice in half. Mike Richards coming over and making sure that the speed was nullified. That's the speed zone between the blue lines, and the Flyers doing a great job of controlling it.
Final minute of the period. Flyers move up the goal. Last minute of the period. Number 1 in game 3. Don't want repetition. How about scoring one? Powell looking for it. Kept it alive. And now Powell has it in the corner, trying to turn away from Eaton. Powell with a pass. Oh, it was meant for Gagne, but Malkin got his stick on it. Sikora the other way. Sikora, good check. Tiemann reaching in with his stick. And now moving back in the counter rush is Richards. 25 seconds in the period. Richards' shot blocked. Now Gill got his big body in the way of that one. Crosby to Malkin. Malkin will just play it deep into Philadelphia. Final 13 seconds of the period. Tiemann hanging on to the puck. Time running out. He's going to try one home run pass. Hartnell reaching for it. 3 seconds. Hartnell holding on, running out of time. Tried to force it all the way across, but the Penguins there. And that is it for a very entertaining period number 1. Fleury stops 12 Philadelphia shots. Miron got in the way of 13 offerings for the Penguins. No score after 1 in game 4. Tonight's Flyers-Penguins first period was brought to you by McDonald's McCafe Coffees. Try hotter iced mochas, lattes, and cappuccinos. McDonald's, I'm loving it. By GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. And brought to you by Buick Pontiac GMC. Visit bpgsuperdeals.com. Here's what's coming up between periods 1 and 2. Coatsy's Corner deals with Claude Giroux. We'll also hear from Michael Barkan and Al Morgatti with their thoughts on period number 1. Plenty of highlights and analysis. Coatsy's Corner after these messages. Tonight's second period from the Wachovia Center is brought to you by Dodge. Live strong, live bold, live now. Dodge, grab life. And by Virtua, the specialist in top knots. Game 4, Eastern Conference quarterfinals. A lot of action, though, as the teams set to start period number 2.
And our numbers presented by Dodge inside the game, the first period. You can see the numbers are pretty even, but the goaltenders ruled, especially Marc-Andre Fleury, without his performance, this game would not be 0-0. Penguins also had five failed clears, which is a real indication of how sharp the Flyers were in putting pressure on the Penguins deep in their zone. No blood yet.
And one of the reasons no blood, two of the reasons I should say, right there, on the left, Andre Fleury. They were both outstanding. Both teams, as with any club, trying to create a lot of traffic around the netminders. I thought both teams did that, but the goalie still made the saves.
My vote so far for hit of the game, because I don't produce anymore, is the hit by Mike Richards on Scuderi. That was just scary how good that was. But that's my vote so far, guys.
Scary on Scuderi? Are there play on words there, Coatsy?
We're moving. You didn't know it, right?
Not intentionally.
We're moving you up to associate producer, by the way.
Well, thank you very much.
There'll be a little extra something in your paycheck this week.
Yes, Chris Cajaro and Steve Coates, co-assistant producers. Underway, period number two. Penguins are offside, and, well, Rusty Fedotenko decided to take the shot anyhow, and that'll get a word or two from Mike Knuble.
Tad late.
Play was clearly offside.
Thought that Mike Knuble had one of the most physical periods he's had in a long time.
Mike, of course, had some things go wrong in Pittsburgh early in this series, and he is the type that holds himself accountable. You know, he is determined to make something happen in this series from a positive standpoint. Busy night in the playoffs. Five playoff games. You look at the scores. Upper right-hand corner of your screen. First ever Stanley Cup playoff game. The Nationwide Arena in Columbus taking place tonight. Unfortunately, the Red Wings have taken the early lead down. Unfortunately, if you are one of those Columbus Blue Jacket fans, they've been going crazy for that team here in March and April. Let's get to the puck here. Mike Richards turns with it. They'll end up fake. Last to get it in from the red line, wrist it, but it got caught up. Jordan Staal finally. Richards does turn it deep to Pittsburgh ice. The Flyers change lines. Looks or pick. And this center, Albert's knocked it down. Lupo will poke it free. Andrew Jones, the long outlet is right on the money to Hartnell. Hartnell with a deke and written down by Orpik. Penalty. Blade call that puck off of Eaton in front and then kicked out of there by Fleury. And play is stopped. The Flyers will get another power play.
I think it's Matt Cook again for interference.
This goes down, and I'm just going to look over to see how the Pittsburgh bench reacts to this. This goes down as a dumb penalty. As Matt Cook let his emotions get a hold of himself, and he just gets up and he just drills Jeff Carter. Now, it's before this, but along the far wall, he just, right there, for no reason, just drilled him. And the referee, Kevin Pollock, standing right there watching it. He gets interference. It could have been roughing. Could have been anything. It doesn't matter. But that's not the kind of penalty you can take in a playoff series. Just very undisciplined. Now, this is one of the dangers of being down here. Watch this stick. Bang. Got me right in the head.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Should have kept your fisherman hat on.
My fisherman hat.
You know, when you put that on, I feel like fish and chips for some reason.
I'll have them up to you.
The power of suggestion.
Do you want two plays?
Please.
Fish and chips, right? All right. Flyers with the puck here. Joffrey Lupul. Power play number four. For the Flyers. Hartnell shuffles it back out. Shot Carl. Save made. Fleury. Lupul was trying to redirect that, but it went right in on the Pittsburgh goaltender.
Matt Carl was hoping that somebody could get there in time to screen as well. The only place you don't want it to end up is in the goaltender's glove. But he was being pressured, and the coverage couldn't get there. The screen, at least, in front of Fleury. Flyers very aggressive in front of Fleury. But the Penguins do a great job of blocking shots that don't even get there.
Alvin won that draw. Penguins again winning the faceoff war in this game, as they have all series long. Pierre Talbot. Richards will take over. Mike Richards deliberately towards center. On Talbot. And the puck deep into the Pittsburgh zone. Pierre tries to get it after it. Knuble knocked it down, and they say he did so with his stick.
was legal. Here's Rare trying to center. And he was there. Puck never made it through. Now teaming it. Cross Richards. Richards is back across ice. Giroux in the middle for Gagne. Tipped away. Good read there by the Penguins. Pascal Dupuis, and it went out of play.
Mike Richards immediately started checking his stick. And I thought what he thought, that his stick must have been broken. The way that slap pass misfired.
I don't think he intended to go to Giroux on that one. Or if he did, he wanted to have more on it.
He immediately checked his stick. I thought, gosh, the stick had to have broken, but he went to the bench with the same stick.
Good keep by Coburn to Carter. Carter's pass tipped away by Scuderi. Another good read there. Lupul is ready to fire. Puck never got to him. Scuderi checked by Hartnell. Great hustle by Hartnell to keep that puck alive. Lupul back to Hartnell. Trying to find Carter. Bounces into the slot. Coburn! Swing and a miss as that puck was chopped away. Now Carter back out for Carl. To Carter. 18 seconds in the power play. Carter whipping one from the angle. That missed the target. And invariably go down the ice. It did. There's Coburn. Cross ice for Hartnell. Wine fires right into the midsection of Fleury. No further play.
Pretty sticky performance so far by Fleury. Said that one of the keys in this game was crowding him. The Flyers are doing a pretty good job of that. Not only taking the vision away, but hunting for rebounds. But there have not been many rebounds.
Flyers and Lehigh Valley Dairy Farms like to thank their guests in the family section. 222-222A. Actually a good one. Seaman was expecting, I think, Ryan Parrott over there. There was no one home. And now out of the box, Cook to Kunitz. Kunitz centering! Mira ends up in the net. And the puck ends up in the net. They score! Crosby went hard to the net. And it's 1-0 Pittsburgh.
Nothing but a little lofted shot at the net. The reason Ryan Parent backed out of the zone and Kimmo Tiimonen had nobody to pass to was that Matt Cook was coming out of the penalty box. And Ryan Parent knew it. Cook got the puck. Was able to drift the shot across. Marty Biron went for it with his glove, but somehow it escaped his glove and just bounced in off of Crosby. Watch Biron here, see what happens.
This is just a saucer's pass. Now watch it hit Crosby. As he's falling to the ice, then as he's moving in, the puck will continue on into the net. As Gagne takes him to the net, it's a great defensive play. You just can't defend against something like that. That's just luck. But the saucer pass is the key. The crowd doesn't like it.
Oh, it's going to be reviewed, though. You have to.
It will be reviewed.
As you gotta say, if that goes off his glove, it would be no goal.
Well, if he was looking the other way and it just happened to glance in off his glove, it would count. If he intentionally directed it in with the glove, it wouldn't count. I think this drop below the glove of Marty Biron, he tried to scoop it up. It looked like it hit the shaft of Crosby's stick, then off his leg, and then perhaps off his glove.
It would appear from right there. Now, we got a better look at that other angle overhead as Crosby himself is looking up to see what goes on, but it would appear that he had really no idea where that puck was coming from when that saucer pass came from
the just right said, of Marty Biron. Said, Coach, he just said, my stick, and I think that pass bounced and hit the shaft of his stick. You don't teach that. You can't even do that. It just happens. Take a look here, Coatsy.
Oh. That hit stick there, but then it hit something else.
It hit his stick, and then it hit his body, and it rolled off his body into the net.
I think that's a good goal, guys.
I do, too. I do, too, because there's just no way in the world you'd have the wherewithal to be able to know where it's at and to be able to still control your body and know where that puck is.
I think Crosby was as anxious to see the replay as everybody else to see what happened on it. But he did pick this out of the air with the shaft of a stick about a foot above his blade.
And again, the call is goal on the ice, so the evidence would have to be conclusive.
Yep.
To Cook, turn that call around.
Cook came out of the penalty box. Kunitz speed supported Cook. He dished to Kunitz. Kunitz across to Crosby.
Give Gagne an awful lot of credit. I mean, you can't defend a guy any better than that.
Ruling on the ice stands, good goal.
That is the rule. With the call. So it's 1-0 Pittsburgh. Crosby will get the goal. Now has himself an 8-game playoff point streak going back to last year.
Well, there was nothing finesse-like about that goal. That was grunt work all the way.
Penguins have struck first.
Kuchin going out the ice. Here's Kunitz. Kunitz back behind net for Crosby. Fires at the respond. Crosby turned back along the boards. Hartnell digs the puck free and steps to center ice with Luke. Carter's trailing. And they say it's onside, but Hartnell was then checked. And the Penguins clear to center ice. And then rips it right back in. Gill after it, so is Carter. Gill will push it out to center ice. Right there is Coburn. Penguins lead this series 2-1, but they have not led within games nearly as much as the Flyers through the first 3-plus games, but they have the lead right now. Long outlet, that's tipped, and it's all the way down, no icing. Coburn back to retrieve. Shuttle ahead. Carl, Flyers get to it. Wiping out, though, was Giroux. And this is odd man rush the other way. Sikora had a chance for a breakaway, and he fumbled the puck away. Now he centers, and it goes on through. Sikora does not look like he is handling the puck or firing it with much authority. Riera going to jab that one through. Now it's Coburn. Malkin will cut that off and clank it off the glass to center. And it's not handled by Powell. He'll have to be back into his own zone to get to it. Banked it for Carl, but that's off the mark. Malkin turns and takes a shot off of Powell. Back out to Eaton. Around behind for Sikora. Sikora to Malkin. Malkin in front. Knocked aside. Back out for Eaton. Around behind Sikora. Sikora for Malkin. Malkin looking dangerous. Penalty upcoming. Malkin got one toward the net. Lunging on top of it is Biron. And there's the hooking infraction. And the Penguins will go to the power play.
This will be a key juncture in this hockey game, obviously, with a 1-0 Penguins lead. Huge kill for Philadelphia. Darryl Powell was guilty of the hook here. And Darryl Powell is probably saying to himself, you know what, I started this mess with that bank pass behind the net that was too hard and too far for Matt Carl.
It's a tough play for a guy that's obviously a lot smaller for Powell, taking on a big guy like Malkin who can keep the stick and the puck so far away.
Power play number 3 for Pittsburgh. They have tallied in each of the games of this series. In fact, the Penguins' power play has been lethal in the recent playoff past. But a turnover here and a chance for the Flyers. It's 2-on-2, Richards and Gagne. Richards will carry it in and overskate Malkin. We'll get it back. 7 straight playoff games with a power play goal. Tying the longest streak in franchise history. The power play during the regular season was pedestrian. Ranked 20th, but in the playoffs, it's been good. Goncha. Crosby back out in front. It found Carter, and he shovels it down the ice. And 5 remaining on the foul penalty. Just over 6 minutes into the second period. Colby Center has been quieted for the moment. Sikora winding it in. Miron will cut the puck off. Gives to Alberts. Hammers it off the glass. Hartnell forces it out to center and then gets to Carter. Carter with speed. Cutting on in. Carter to the backhand. Save! Fleury as he got the arm on it. Aaron will drop the puck back. Well, any worries about Marc-Andre Fleury after giving up 5 goals in game 3 can be thrown aside. He's been tremendous.
Live in the moment. That's the life of the goaltender, especially this time of year. Stay in the moment.
Yeah. He's trying to do just that. Stopped 17 shots thus far.
Penguins are getting a little frustrated. You can see it coming off the ice after that power play. They're getting a little frustrated because they just can't get anything going on these power plays because the Flyers are doing such a great job.
And Guerin's in ahead of the play there offside with just 8 seconds remaining on this particular Pittsburgh Mad advantage. Now's the time to reserve your 2009-2010 season tickets. Guarantee yourself playoff tickets for every game. Enjoy great season ticket holder benefits, including significant discounts from box office pricing and flexible payment plans. Call 215-218-PUCK or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. There's your goal scorer. Richards hoping to become one himself here in this game.
Like Mike Richards, Sidney Crosby doesn't always get it done with finesse.
hobbled. Side of the net trying to get that one back out in front. Power play is over. The Flyers have the puck. Powell out of the box. D-line to the Pittsburgh zone. He'll wind it deep. Gagne running it along for Richards. Sidestepping Eaton. Richards centering Gagne. Shot glove. Save Fleury. Left-handed larceny from Fleury. Keeps his team on top. Crosby gave the Penguins the lead. Fleury moments ago kept them in front. Back in a moment.
Al Morgan with a Stanley Cup update in Carolina. The Canes trying to level it off. Old friend Yoni Pitkinen drives it into Brodeur. Walker walks it around. And Beta by the goalie. 2-0 Canes. That's after one period. Back to JJ and Billy with our action.
All right, Al, thank you very much. We'll keep you updated. Matt Cook with a pass in front. Kennedy backhander. He scores. Tyler Kennedy to the backhand. And the Penguins lead by two.
Boy, I can tell you that the element of surprise worked in the Penguins' favor on this one. This is a red carpet pass by Matt Cook that I don't think anybody in this building, maybe even his own teammates, expected. Check it out. Through a seam with three Flyers, and then Tyler Kennedy's move looked just like the one that Jeff Carter put on in game three.
Identical, but the pass is just super from Cook. Doesn't have to stop, then all of a sudden he knows he can go by two people, not one but two Flyers, and then it's just a matter of, with that quick backhand, Marty's trying to come out and play the puck, but he's got people in front of him and probably picked up on in the last second.
Well, crunch time for Philadelphia. Down 2-1 in the series. They're now down 2-0 in this game. Kennedy's shot saved here. A big rebound played out to center by Philadelphia. Flyers have to have their come-from-behind magic working in this one. Else, down 3-1. And the Philadelphia net stick was tied up. Giroux on the penalty on Pittsburgh. He will not get it. Here's Cook. Dishing it a long stall. Could not reach it. And just threw it through center. Turned over by Orpik. Picked up by Giroux. And then the shot goes wide. Powell in the backhand off the carom. Could not make contact. Oberon keeps it into Powell. Powell off for Giroux. In the slot. Shot. Save made. As again, the pinpoint passing of Giroux. I don't know how he got that out to Danny Briere. But the puck was stopped. And it remains 2-0.
Danny Briere with two unbelievable scoring chances from passes off the stick of Claude Giroux. The first one was a rocket. This last one, he got enough of it to score. But did it end up on the top of Marc-Andre Fleury's pad? I'll give Fleury a lot of credit. He's been in the right spot at the right time.
And the key for Fleury is he had everything tight. No five hole. That was where that puck was going. Everything was tight and closed.
Koskunin's moving that puck to center. And back in, Herrett for Philadelphia. And pass in the middle, Carter. Right wing feed for Lupul. Lupul dancing around. Gill shot! And that one just flutters into the crest on Fleury's jersey and he'll hang on.
Boy, the Flyers have generated enough scoring opportunities to be leading this game, but Marc-Andre Fleury, especially early in the tilt, a huge difference maker. Flyers haven't let up, but still haven't been able to dent the twine.
A lot of work to do. 11:04 remaining second period. Tons of time, and they'll get some help here as Hal Gill is headed to the penalty box. Right off the faceoff, he took down Mike Knubel. Interference call, and the Flyers will get their fifth power play.
The door of opportunity swings open here because Mike Knubel wanted to make something happen. Even if Hal Gill doesn't grab him, he's a moving pick here and trying to keep Mike Knubel from getting into the corner where the puck is.
He's 6'8". All he had to do was move in front of him. But Knubel actually got the step on him. That's when he got himself in trouble.
And Flyers right to work as they win the draw. Gagne to Richards. All the way across. Too many sticks to get through. Briere tried to keep it in the zone. Did once. Twice. And it bounces free. Gagne in the middle. Reaching for it. Knubel. And they'll turn it back and set things up.
Richards. Pagani off the wall. Quick shot. Save. Fleury again in good position. And he was able to grab it.
I'll tell you, he just made a really good defensive play with Sergei Gonchar. Mike Knuble was waiting for the pass. Gonchar got a chunk of it. When it finally got to Gagne, he turned and tried to go high to the glove side.
This time the Penguins win the draw. Scuderi will clear it all the way down. It's 35 seconds into the mat advantage. Timo Timonen starts up. Rips it in from the red line. Gagne first to it. Settles it around. Knuble. His stick on it, Eaton in there. Briere trying to dig it free, rolls to the corner. Scuderi wedged. Knuble away from the puck. Richards absolutely steamrolls Craig Adams, but the Penguins clear. It was a heat-seeking missile in this one. As the Flyers captain. That's Gagne.
Adams looked like he got tasered.
Gagne hitting the referee with that pass attempt at a lead to a clear for the Penguins stall all the way down.
One thing you want to do is you want to keep your head up when Mike Richards is on the ice. He reads as good as anybody, waiting for the guy to admire his pass or look at where he's going to pass, and then he just drills him.
Yeah, you're right, Coach, and that's twice he's just tattooed guys that have been clearing the puck when they've been a man short. That's how he got Scuderi. But Mike Richards, no, he can't stop the clear. He'll go for the kill instead.
15 seconds remaining in this power play. Flyers just not able to get set up. Penguins clear it all the way down. That will leave precious little time for Philadelphia with the man advantage. Out of the box, jump skill. Kyle could not get the puck deep. Tang will swing it around the other way, out of the reach of Gonchar. Off the bench is Aaron Asham for Philadelphia. Backhanding to Hartnell. Hartnell back in front. Asham shot! Save. Fleury rebound jams loose, but there's Crosby. Crosby then tangled up Hartnell and the referee. The puck ahead. There's Crosby getting to it, but he's checked. Flyers look to move back. There's Hartnell gaining the line. Hartnell, straight move in front. Save. Fleury penalty! And the Flyers will get another power play. Tripping the call, they'll go to work with a man advantage again. Meantime, the Flyers captain has found some Penguins in the crosshairs, and he's hit the target. This time it was Adams.
We look at Sergei Gonchar in the penalty box. He's going to pick up the penalty. Now watch, most players always love to be able to go to their backhand, protect the puck with their bodies, and then cut in to the goal. Then they'll be able to come on that forehand. Right here, Gonchar, he gets the skate before he gets the stick. That's why there's a penalty. Flyers go to the power play.
That team in a shot, and that one glanced off of something wide. Richards right back to Gagne. And now Richards turning. All the way across, the shot, Briere! Fleury absorbs that one, and no rebound. He's been sticky as Fleury in this game. I'd like to say, Bill, the Stanley Cup playoffs are on Versus. Don't miss a single second. Check TV listings or Versus.com for full schedule. So far, the first round has been tremendous. Of course, this series, we've seen that, but checking out some of the others. Off the draw, that shot. From Briere, Knuble. Checked by Stahl. Pushes the puck in along with Asher. It squirts free to Eaton on the backhand, and he got it off Stahl to center ice. Flyers with their sixth attempt on the power play. They need a goal here badly. Richards chips and chases. Fleury out of his net, but he sent it up before Richards. A shot! Knuble, and Fleury made the save as he was diving back in. Penalty.
Penalty tripping.
I didn't see it. Tripping the call.
I didn't either.
No one's sure who the penalty's on here. The referee is screaming to the players.
Denny Darroux might be the only guy in the building that saw it.
Must be Mike Richards.
Let's take a look and see as the puck goes. Richards is going, what are you talking about? Let's see if Richards knocks Fleury down when Fleury comes out. That's the only thing I can think of because everything happened so quickly. Let's take a look. Oh, Is that what he's calling a tripping? By that the fact that he caught him with his left skate as he was moving in? It, right here, watch the left skate get the right skate of Fleury. Well, that's just incidental contact. You can't, there was no intent there to trip.
Didn't look like it, but an indication of what kind of zone Marc-Andre Fleury is in. That even when he was in a code red survival mode situation, he falls down and makes the save.
Crowd, you're wondering what that groan was about. They just got a look at that angle we showed. And obviously not in agreement with that call. So it's 4-on-4 hockey for the next minute. And then a power play for the Penguins for about 45 seconds or so. Coburn moving up. Coburn trying to go wide on Eaton, could not. He chops it back. Carter's there and he fans on the shot. Fedotenko drops the puck for Kennedy, turning on the speed. Carter in pursuit. Kennedy comes to a stop, turns with it, and then shuffles it along, hoping for Fedotenko. Jones trying to deal with him. And he got some help from Scott Hartman. Hartman for Randy Jones. Can't pass into the middle as a turnover at the Pittsburgh line. Letang the other way. Letang in, and he'll just softly play it deep into Philadelphia ice. Carl Carter couldn't handle it out of his skates. 15 seconds remaining on the penalty to Gonchar. He'll just hop right onto the power play for the Penguins. Crosby. Bergeron tipped it to the corner. Orpik got it back from Malkin. Checked by Carl, taken down by Carl, but Crosby there to get the puck, and now Malkin. Penguins right to the power play. Carl, good play. Tipped the puck free. Jones a chance to clear in the backhand, didn't get it past Gonchar cleanly, but it does bounce eventually to Giroux, who moved it out to center ice. 32 seconds on the Pittsburgh power play. Here's Letang hustling it in across the line to the middle, and meeting him there was Gagne tipping the puck to center. Letang will get it back. Made a change. And for one rush for the power play for Pittsburgh. Gonchar to Crosby. Crosby attracts traffic. And the Malkin is cross ice pass tipped. And then a diving swat by Giroux clears the zone. Quick pass. Oh, Crosby was there and eluded him. Goes to Bira. The power play over. Fires back to full strength. Coburn ahead. And Powell guided to Richards. Richards in the middle. Tiiminen. Tiiminen swinging wide. Tiiminen checked by Eaton. There's Knubel and then sent past Richards. In comes Coburn. Back around behind for Knubel. Turning with it and then back for Richards. Richards digs it off to Dasher. Turns with it. Finesse it back to Carl. Carl or Richards. Richards to Powell. Slot shot. Glove save. Fleury with traffic in front of him. That was a heck of a save. It remains 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Al Morgani with a Stanley Cup update. The good news in Columbus, they finally host the home playoff game. The bad news, those Detroit Red Wings are there. Cleary to Zetterberg. That makes it 3-0 after two. No warm-up time for the Red Wings this time. They're firing on all cylinders. JJ, Billy?
All right, Al, they're party poopers, are those Red Wings. They go in there and spoil the party at Nationwide Arena so far.
Speaking of all cylinders, the Penguins have had two scoring chances in this period. Scored on both of them. The Flyers have had 10.
Jones, with a float one in. In front, hoping for Giroux, was knocked down. Secor didn't clear. Jones, a shot at a bouncing puck. It trickles toward the other corner. Carcillo, in along the gill, will knock that down. Head for Billy Guerin. And out through center ice it goes. Less than 5 minutes remaining in this second period. Jones wrapped up by Staal. All ends up with the puck. Giroux leans on him. So strong. Look at Giroux. Smaller man, and he won the battle. Now Giroux starts back the other way. Swarmed upon, had a stick go flying into the middle of that pile. Giroux still after it as the puck goes into the Pittsburgh zone. Now he's going to take on Hal Gillen. Win! Cross ice pass, the shot. Save Fleury. Oh, Claude Giroux, a magician right there. The only thing lacking a finish.
He's going to have to take it all the way to the house himself.
Here's Cook. Two by who else but Giroux, and knocked into the corner. Giroux's physical play on display here. Now Jones by the net is checked. Talbot picks it up. His centering pass for Cook, his shot blocked. Tiiminen got in the way of that.
Puck bouncing free. Luke will after it. Didn't get to it. Kennedy is there. Deep centered. I think that might have hit the post and bounced in front. And now it's Hartnell for Luke, but it goes out to center. Gonchar winds the puck into the Philadelphia zone. Hartnell stopped by Dupuis. Second stab at it. Headed to the neutral zone. Jones letting Tiemannin play that one. No, Tiemannin has a look. He'll scoop one. Fires the glove of Gonchar. 3:22 remaining in this second period. Orpik ahead to Crosby. Crosby dancing on in, then turning around with it. Crosby swinging along the boards. Adams could not come up with it. Biron for Hartnell. Hartnell's pass off escape to Tiemannin. Tiemannin ahead for Lupul. Joffrey Lupul gains the line, stops, waits, floats. On off of Fleury at the side of the net. Sent back up the wall. There's Lupul again. There's the glass with that. Hartnell run off the play by Gonchar. Guys with a heavy advantage in shots and chances here in the second period, but the Penguins have the two. The count found the net. Coburn to Carl. Now ahead, the long cross ice pass from Gagne finds Knubel. Knubel's shot blocked. Eaton got in the way of that, and Richards can't keep it in his zone. Barreling past him is Malkin. Malkin up the right wing with a shot blocked off by Carl. Malkin back after it, but the Flyers are there. And Coburn looking for the outlet. Knubel tried to catch up to it, bats it into the zone. And to dig it free was Richards. It's Knubel instead. But Malkin took it away. Now Richards gets it back to Gagne. For Carl, across, right along the line, kept in the corner, Richard centering, but right there in good position was Letang to clear. Looking down toward 2 minutes remaining in this second period. Briere will send it in. Fleury stops it, sets it up for Eaton. Flyers will peel back on the line change. Crowd still hanging in there, trying to urge their Flyers on. Would love to light the lamp here late in this period. Stahl rumbling to center. He'll chip it in. Now waits for it to get to the trapezoid and steers to Alberts. Now ahead, Giroux. Long cross ice pass for Powell, trying to tip it past Orpik, could not. Orpik ahead for Stahl. Checked by Parent. Kennedy after it. Giroux in there as well, but it's Kennedy who controls. Back out to Orpik. Across ice it goes. Skidari, he'll just roll it in along for Kennedy. Kennedy with a pass to Stahl, centering. That's read beautifully. Tipped back out towards center Orpik. That was Giroux, by the way, who read that play and tipped it away. Now Albert's good hard work in the corner. Giroux to it. Rink wide feed for Briere. 3-on-3 to center. Briere gaining the Pittsburgh line. Briere dancing on in. Checked. Puck sitting there. Giroux picks it up. Giroux on the wall, and he's taken off the puck this time by Cook, and Crosby motors up with it. Crosby marked by Tiemannin. Behind the back pass, and Powell is ready for that. He turns with it, got slashed, but moves ahead. Here's Powell. Team rolling through center. Powell, quick shot blocked off. Puck played high off the glass and then deflects out of play. No penalty. Crowd wants one, but it hit the glass on its way into the crowd.
Take a look at our Wachovia. A great check of the game. This is the great annihilation of the game right there. Skinneri's going to try to move that puck, but look, he's not looking because he's behind the net. So the last thing he's going to see is Mike Richards. Richards comes in a position where he's going to catch him right at the right time. Absolutely outstanding hit. You can see the hit leaders in this series. But Skinneri will remember that one, boys.
Yeah, if he can remember it. Surprised he didn't get hit that hard.
Foggy in your mind. Hartnell chopping that one toward the net. He'll cut it off, but turned it back over to Hartnell. His pass, reaching for it. Lupul, turn, shot, save. Fleury, rebound tipped, and it will dribble on out to center ice. Penalty on Philadelphia, evidently. The Flyers touch the puck, the whistle blows, and Pittsburgh will end up getting the power play here late in the second.
Top right of the screen, Scott Hartnell coming in and using Hal Gill as a bowling pin.
Too long after the puck had been played by the Penguins in front. Not even sure if Gill did get his stick on the puck. He was reaching for it. So the Penguins with the power play. Letang a wrister, and that floats to the glove of Bjorn. No deflection executed. And the puck back out to center. Final 6 seconds of the period. The Penguins, though, will begin the third period on the power play. And that's tough when you're the Flyers trying to build a comeback and facing a power play on the fresh sheet of ice. Flyers outplayed the Penguins here in the second. But the Penguins get a great period from that man right there, Marc-Andre Fleury. They get a goal from Sidney Crosby, a goal from Tyler Kennedy, and they lead it 2-0 through 40 minutes. Tonight's Flyers-Penguins second period was brought to you by Independence Blue Cross. When you have the most preferred health plan in the region, you'll never feel alone. And by your Quality Plus Ford dealers. Here's what we have in store for you between periods 2 and 3. Al Morgani, Michael Parkin, get you up to date on all that's happening in the Stanley Cup playoffs on this night. They'll also analyze this one. So will Bill and I. Penguins, 20 minutes away from a 3-1 series lead. Flyers hope they have something to say about that. Back in a moment. Tonight's third period on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Jaguar. Visit your local Jaguar dealer to experience the thrilling performance of the new 510-horsepower Jaguar XFR. Also brought to you by the Pennsylvania Lottery, benefits older Pennsylvanians every day. Must be 18 or older to play. Please play responsibly. For the start of third period action, the Flyers will try to become the first team in these 2009 Stanley Cup playoffs to trail after two and come from behind and win. 14 for 14 are the teams that have that lead after two, but the Flyers have been a good come from behind team all season long, and they will try to use that to their advantage here in a very important period of hockey for them right here. They begin this power this period on a short-handed situation here as they have 1:35 to kill on Hartnell's penalty. So the Penguins on the power play. Here's Gagne. And to keep it away from Malkin, it was turned back to the point by Crosby. No one was home, and Gonchar sent it back to Fleury. Clean sheet of ice, which makes the power play more effective, obviously. Complete some of those longer passes. Here's one ahead. Now Kunitz in front, the shot! Crosby hit the post, rebound Gonchar, and then it's tipped away by Richards. A lot of hesitation after that. Some of the players, I think, thought it might have gone in.
I think it hit the crossbar.
So the Flyers catch a break. It's Crosby, went higher to the net. Here's Malkin, dancing at the line. Parent trying to stay with him. Not go on for Guerin, and that will squeeze out to center ice. 32 seconds remain on the power play. Normally ahead for Eaton. Cross ice pass, and it makes its way to Stahl. Stahl, inside outside move, and he's hammered down by Alberts. Puck retrieved though by Sikora to Gonchar for a shot. Save, Miron rebound. Alberts. Alberts with a pass. Carter moving on up with it. Sees Giroux now, but Giroux is stationary. Gets it back to Alberts. Alberts then will spin it around to the other side of the ice, and that will send Stahl roaring out to center ice. Giroux a chop at him. Stahl carries on. Coburn will make that Jones back to knock it away, but to the point it goes out to center back in. The more pick, and so the play is offside. Just 2 seconds remain on the Hartnell penalty.
Marty Biron with an anxious moment. Chris Kunitz with a little saucer pass to Sidney Crosby. Crossbar all the way.
That's a talent there by Crosby, just to be able to take and let that puck hit his stick, and he's going to let the stick kind of blade open up a little bit just so that it goes up and hits the crossbar. He wanted to get up over that left side of Biron, got a little bit too much air underneath, but that just shows you the talent this guy.
Yeah, not much curve on his stick either, coach. He kind of helps him on those backhand chances. that last PK unit that was out there for the Flyers had Jeff Carter and Claude Giroux together. They don't usually kill together, but John Stevens looking for a little offense even on the PK.
Shot Coburn, hits Hartnell, pow, then fired one upstairs. Bouncing around Briere, but he could not maneuver through traffic. Carl tried to keep it in, could not, does get it to Pouce. Slashed, no penalty. Offside is called at the Pittsburgh line. Powell wants to know where the slashing call was.
Goes right toward the referee.
Well, this game will encore tonight at 10:30 on the Comcast Network, and then at 1:30 in the morning on Comcast Sportsnet. You'll always catch something different when you see it the second time around. Crosby readying himself for a draw. He's been dynamite. He wins another faceoff.
He was awful when he turned pro. He just worked at it every year.
Dupuis comes around behind now. Crosby trying between the legs pass. Steven unable to come up with it. That really is the mark of a great player. You find the weak areas of the game and work at it. It was Carter's shot, save made for it. It's easy to go out and practice the things you do well. It's not so easy, certainly not as much fun to practice the things you don't do well, but Crosby is known for that. Right now, Bill, I'll make this assessment of his game. There aren't any things he doesn't do well anymore.
No, listen, he's been forced out of his comfort area. He's a rush player. His eyes get bigger as he approaches the offensive blue line with speed. He hasn't had that speed to work with because the Flyers have done such a good job. So what has he done? He scored a goal based on grunt work. He scored an ugly goal because the pretty stuff isn't there for him.
Al Gill loses control back into his own zone. Doing some rough treatment in the corner. Knubel doing the grunt work along the boards. Gagne hoping he can get him the puck. Now Knubel will try Richards. Try to step in front. He was checked. Got it toward Gagne, but it's tipped away by Kunitz. Over and back toward his own zone with it as Kunitz pursues. And then turning in his pass to Carl. Now we'll flip it through, and now cross ice Knubel to Gagne. Gagne for Richards, a shot, and he just missed it. Missed it wide. Coburn will backhand that one right to Gill. Gill to Kunitz, and the former Duck will backhand into the Philadelphia zone.
So much easier to play with the lead. The Pittsburgh Penguins can now let the puck do the work, chip it in. And what makes it easier is that you know what direction the puck has to go in at all times. It just keeps going forward, and it just keeps going deep when you get the chance.
There's a ricochet, but Dorsillo beat the puck into the zone. It's an offside call.
What a nice little pass from Gagne to Richards. This did not miss by that much. He was trying to beat Fleury high to the glove, and you'd better be real high because the glove has been hot.
And it's a tougher shot for a left-handed shot because he doesn't have the angle. So he's got to get it up. You saw that Fleury obviously out cutting down the angle, but boy, it wasn't very much because it had the right track because he just absolutely drilled it.
Dorsillo just absolutely drilled Brooks Orpik on the forecheckers. I was trying to get in on the forecheck when they can. Alberts. Board setter and then playing it all the way down. No icing here. Fleury will play. Headed to the boards. Flyers had a crack at it, but Ashton could not get his stick on it. Stahl moves up. Left wing feed for Cook, and that wound up in the Philadelphia bench. And a whistle stops play.
Jordan Stahl had four scoring chances in the first period, but right about now he is going to be really showing off his defensive skills because he's one of the best shutdown centers in the game. And that's what the Penguins are trying to do here with a two-goal lead, is just shut down. Jordan Stahl is not the gambling type, so he's going to be conservative and focus on D.
Matt Carl, fluttering one that's batted out of the zone by Eaton. Scooped right back in by Coburn, but Letang is there. This Letang out from behind his net. Many of the defensemen backhanding, hit a teammate in the back. Giroux will play to the corner. Coburn reverses, fires in good shape to handle. Briere in the middle, Giroux reaching for it, tipped away. Giroux knocked down, stick went flying, penalty. Flyers will get their seventh power play of the game. Steve Walkham taking, or I should say Dennis LaRue taking a look back. Steve Walkham's his boss. Dennis LaRue making sure that nothing untoward was happening, Coetzee, after that whistle.
Well, that's the key. You see, you got the penalty all right. Eaton's going to pick up the tripping penalty. Talbot's trying to goad Powell into getting a,
a little bit going there, so maybe trying to get things even. But watch the left. See right there, gets the hip into him. Lost the stick. Let's see if he got a little bit of the knee. Yeah, he got the knee into him. That's where you see that last replay. On the first one, you thought, oh, maybe hip. Second one, you saw the knee. So Flyers with a great opportunity to draw within one here. This is huge.
Tripping the call. 5-12 the time. Higher power play, which is in the top 10 of the NHL all season long. Calling upon it to come up huge here. Richards dancing on in. Hammered in the corner. Kadri got his glove on it, but couldn't control it. Out in front, Knubel shot, save made. Rebound Richards, two teaming in. Teaming in looks. Back to Richards, shot, save Fleury. Again, the athleticism of Fleury as he flashed across to make the save, and the Penguins clear. Teaming in for Briere, he could not come up with it. Kadri for Gonchar. That one hit something on the Pittsburgh bench. Faceoff will go back deep into the Penguin zone. We want to hear from you and who you think is the Verizon Wireless star of the game. Perhaps Marc-Andre Fleury. He's about 27 shots. He might be one of the candidates for sure. Just grab your mobile phone and text the word star to 53695 for your vote. Standard charges apply or go to csnphilly.com. Flyers win the draw. Here's Coburn with a shot. And that was blocked by Gonchar and cleared by Orpik. Coburn into the boards awkwardly, but appears to be all right. The Flyers go back to get the puck. Already halfway through this man advantage. Carl moves on in. A weak shot. Stick save. Fumbling it a little bit was Fleury, so a gather and cover.
The thing that is so impressive about Marc-Andre Fleury is that besides being a great athlete, he reads the play so extremely well. That last save he made on Mike Richards on the pass from Kimmo Timonen, he was ready for it. He was there waiting for Mike Richards.
You're right, Billy. Everything was in place. I mean, you got the pass. You got Richards as a left-hand shot for the one-timer. And it's just a matter, you figure you got that wide open net, and he just anticipates so well, and he throws that left pad out with that butterfly and covers the whole bottom of the net.
Now Gill, swarmed upon by Giroux and Carter. Gill wrapping up. Giroux still won the battle. He got the puck to Hartnell, and he couldn't do anything with it. Had the puck bounce away from him as he was trying to get it out in front. There was some space. He got it back, does Hartnell. To Carl. Off the wall with it, all the way across. Back to Carl. Carl to Giroux. Giroux rotates out with it. His pass down low. Carter holds. Fired it in front. Loose puck. They jam for it. No goal. No goal. The light went on, but no goal as LaRue was right on the scene. The spotlight is blaring on the scrum in front, but it's still a 2-0 hockey game.
Boy, that looked like a drop down right behind Marc-Andre Fleury. So close to the line. I'm anxious to get a look at this.
Quite sure why the play was whistled down.
Oh, hit the post and then dropped down behind him. Watch the far post.
Oh, yep, right there.
What I was looking for on the original one, right there, you can see it hit the pipe and then come right back into Fleury. And then Matt Carl, he just said, what the heck? I'm going to try to drill him right to the net, and that's what he does.
Here comes Matt Carl. Just going for the rugby push.
I was kind of hoping that Hal Gill would grab onto it, then it would have been a penalty shot.
He was fishing for it. There's teaming in. Final second of the power play is shot, smothered by Fleury, and no further play. The Flyers now 0-7 with the power play. Penguins to lead by 2.
Al Morgan with the Stanley Cup update in Carolina. The Canes may be a little too comfy with that 3-goal lead. Who's that little guy sliding free? That'll be Brian Gionta all alone. Good night. 3-1 after 2. Gionta brings the Devils back. Make a game of it. Hope we have a game coming up here in Philadelphia, too. JJ, Billy.
We shall see, Al. Flyers down by two. Still 12:47 remaining in this third period. Flyers have now poured 32 shots Marc-Andre Fleury's way, and he's gotten in the way of all of them. Kiminen keeps the puck in. Floats one toward the net. Knocked down. Lupul shot. Shoulder save. Rebound ricocheting around. They scrum for it. Marcello after it, but he could not.
Fleury's lost his mask.
And they usually blow it dead as soon as that's the case. And there's your whistle.
Well, right away, you see that whole skirmish right in front, but Fleury loses his mask by rule. And I don't think they saw it initially. That's why you saw the puck come out of the zone. By rule, as soon as the goaltender loses his mask, the puck has to be blown dead. Let's watch, though, because there's a lot of activity here.
Fleury tried to clear it with that swing, and he missed. Who else? Darryl Powell right on top of him.
Well, Fleury with another save there. He was not credited with a save by the scorers here, but he clearly made that shoulder save.
Sometimes the shots on goals aren't really an indication of what's happened in the game, but the Flyers have 32 shots. 28 of them have been scoring chances.
Wow. You can miss the net and hit a post or something like that and have a scoring chance, but it's just to say that that's not 32 harmless shots. The Flyers have fired his way. Carcillo trying to dive past the Penguin. Brought one into penalty. Penguins are probably saying dive. Either way, nothing is called. His Kunitz moving up. Hello. Crosby will let that go. Less than 12 minutes to play. So Parent jams it around the other way for Powell. For Parent, he's got to deal with Kennedy. That's a penalty. Kennedy got his arm around Parent, holding the call. Another power play chance for Philadelphia.
It'll be number 8. Flyers can't ask for anything
Pittsburgh
more than this.
48. This is not a good penalty to take in the offensive zone. Now, right there, all he's got to do is let him go. You got a 2-0 lead. But what he does is he gets the stick right into him, gets the arm. Look, he hooked the arm. As soon as he hooked the arm, the referee was there to pick up on it.
Kennedy sits. Penguins win the draw, and Gonchar rips it past Richards. He's got a piece of it, but cannot keep it in the zone. Kiminen turning away from Staal. Long pass up, taken by Briere. Briere with speed in. Hands off to Knubel, and he'll twist it back to Richard. Digging it off the wall. Wines his pass. Turning with it in front, now looking for Briere. And it's instead back out. Richard shot, drilled it wide. Briere trying to tuck it in. Fleury reaches back, and he kept it out. And then Gonchar, Briere with some pushing and shoving. Briere so good on the doorstep. He was digging away for that puck, but somehow Fleury got back.
So often the shot that goes wide is the monster that a goaltender can't deal with. You talked about Fleury's athleticism, JJ. Look at this. He came back with his left hand because his right hand was tied up. Watch this. Watch what he does with his glove hand on this play. Are you kidding me?
And that's just absolutely spectacular, and that makes it even more spectacular that Briere is a right-handed shot, so he's facing. So the effort there, or the power, is in favor of Briere.
Gagne shot, save, Fleury rebound, squeezes free, and Talbot is able to clear all the way down. 1:18 still remaining. Flyers continue to get their chances. Ooh. Hearing it from the crowd, they are impatient. A sellout crowd. They understand the importance of the next 10:44. Gagne around. Knubel. The point Richards will move it in, but into heavy traffic. Lost it, and Talbot cleared it up into the Pittsburgh bench. The faceoff will go back to the left of Fleury.
The one-man show, Marc-Andre Fleury. Yeah, he's a butterfly fly goalie, and yes, in case you missed it and just tuned in, he is lightning fast, not only on his feet, but with his glove.
Billy, would you say that he was rushed a little bit when he was taken number one overall?
Well, the Penguins were a bad team. They actually kept him in the minors a year longer than they had to coach him because of his contract. They didn't want to have to pay him a big bonus, so yeah, it was rushed. He was in a chaotic situation that's really straightened out in Pittsburgh.
He's been good in chaotic situations in this game.
Carl takes it. Stick up high. No penalty. Two on one. Penguin stall shot. Save Mira.
And oh, and they blow play dead. He clearly moved the puck along. The Flyers were going to set sail the other way, but it was blown dead.
Stick up high on Matt Carl from Matt Cook. That wasn't picked up. You see the ref in the background had two people between him and Matt Carl, so it's a bit of an obstacle there, but the high guy didn't see it either.
33 seconds, all that remains on this Philadelphia power play. Coburn starting up. Pass to a covered Carter. Coburn got it back, but an attempt to get the puck into the zone. Caught off at the Pittsburgh bench. Now's the time to reserve your 2009-2010 season tickets. Guarantee yourself playoff tickets for every game. Enjoy great season ticket holder benefits, flexible payment plans, exclusive VIP experiences, discounts, and box office pricing. 215-218-PUCK, the number to call. Check out the Flyers website. Carl ahead. Carter, right wing dish. Giroux shot. Save. Fleury took that one right in the midsection. Giroux flexing his glove as though he might have been slashed.
That's one of those situations. Now, Giroux's a right-hand shot. So, obviously, his stick is in a bad angle looking for the corner. All he's trying to do is get a shot and try to create something. But all he's seeing, let's look it over his shoulder. All he sees right there is Fleury. Maybe a little light to Fleury's left, but, boy, he did a great job coming out into that butterfly again and making a great save on Giroux.
So time winding down on this 8th Philadelphia man advantage. And we pass the midpoint now of period number 3. Still 2-0 Pittsburgh. Carl lobbing one into the corner. Follows it in himself. It pops free. Flyers get in. And Vigor on the forecheck. The roof for Powell. Instead it's Eaton. Pinching his parent. Puck bounces to Malkin. Finally is one added out to center right. And then bunted into the Philadelphia zone. There's team in it. Hopping it back to Parent. And a check. Ruppel there. Ruppel hoists one deep to Pittsburgh ice. Again, the advantaging shots heavily for the Flyers, as it was in the second period. And now the 36-22 advantage for the game. Of course, helped along by a lot of power play time, but they just have not been able to solve Fleury.
Almost 13 minutes of power play time for the Flyers tonight.
Now they're having trouble getting the puck in at Pittsburgh zone with any kind of speed, although they recover it here. Richards off the side of the net. Malkin gets it to the other corner. Carcillo there. Richards digging it off the wall. Back out. Cross ice it comes. Alberts back in the middle. Carcillo shot hit the post. Rebound Alberts. That goes behind the net. They try to center it. Letang flips it along, and now Jones will keep it in. Back behind the net. Richards. Vanessa's his way in front. Rebound Carcillo. He scores! If at first you don't succeed, try, try again. Carcillo rams it home. His first goal as a Flyer. And it's 2-1. Carcillo scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
Danny Carcillo must have thought this moment would never happen, especially in a game like this, because of the way Marc-Andre Fleury is playing. He had one scoring chance that rang off the post, but Mike Richards made all of this happen with his patience. He pulled it out front, and the puck bounced right out to Carcillo. I don't care what your name is, you weren't going to stop that shot.
And watch, Pittsburgh gets mesmerized by the puck. They're all looking for it because they figure Richards is coming with a stuffer. That puck comes off the side of the net, and Carcillo's all by himself, and all of a sudden, we got ourselves a hockey game.
Shot here by Lupo, handled by Fleury. This place has erupted. It is rocking here in South Philly. There's your cause. Carcillo reaches for the heavens. Flyers within one. Soak it in. Crowd spent the entire timeout saluting the Flyers, cringing the Flyers. They're all on their feet. There's a shot of Dan Carcillo on the Big Arena scoreboard. He lifted his arms up to say, let me hear you. They're letting him hear it.
The Flyers within one. Bouncing puck right back to Fleury. He'll cover it. We'll get another roar from the crowd.
Boy, the ice has been tilted down towards Marc-Andre Fleury most of this game, especially in the third period. The scoring chances 10-3 for the Flyers. Here was Danny Carcillo. He said, let me hear it. He had power over 19,000 people.
Oh, dude, this place went absolutely wild. It was deafening.
Still is. Taminen looking for Lupo, but instead Gill. Gill will play it out to center ice. Jones cuts it off for Philadelphia. His pass intercepted by Kunitz. They'll force it back into the Philadelphia end. Emo Taminen with it. Man still standing. Taminen looked for the home run pass there for Lupo. It was cut off. Flyers will get it back. Team's changing as Taminen steps up. Taminen to Hartnell. Hartnell hit Taminen as he tried to dump that puck deep. Taminen did not see it. As it bounced to the corner, and now Guerin will lob one out for Stahl's. Got some ice to work with. Tried to close that off. It was Alberts. He did. But Stahl with his strength behind the net. Works it free. Centered it. Good play there. The Flyers break it up. That was Claude Giroux tipping it away. Powell the other way with speed. His shot, though. It was off the stick and into the safety netting. Great stuff here at the Wachovia Center, and tonight on Sportsnet, a recap of this game. Highlights from the Phillies Brewers series opener and a look at the safeties in this year's draft class. All on Sportsnet tonight at 10 only on Comcast Sportsnet. And they roar again.
Wow, this is unbelievable. I don't think this building's ever been any louder.
I support Philadelphia sports fans give their teams. Tremendous. Albert's a shot saved by Fleury. The rebound out to Cook. Now get it to center ice. All over after. Run off the play by Palazzi. Backhands in. Albert couldn't come up with it. Neither could Kennedy. The puck in the corner. Albert didn't see it at first. He certainly sees Kennedy, though, and he gets a piece of him. But Stahl picks up the puck. Back out to the point, kept in by Gonchar. Down low, Kennedy. Fighting off Alberts. Tyler Kennedy. And a little knack for the Flyers to deal with in this series. He scored a couple of big goals. Kennedy for Stahl. Stahl. Twisting and turning. Taken in by Parent. And now the Flyers have it. And move it ahead. Powell. Across for Parent. Parent's pass off Giroux and into the Pittsburgh zone. Gonchar back for Arizona. And he hammers it. Malkin ahead. Trying to keep it in. Unable to do so is Carl. And here goes Fedotenko with speed. The shot! Missed it. Bounces to the side of the net. Biron sliding back. Does he have it? Yes. That puck took a strange hop off the boards after the missed shot and nearly found its way in. He'll be back.
Let's take a look at our Toyota turning point. Sidney Crosby gives the Pens a 1-0 lead. Then all of a sudden, Matt Cook is going to make a great pass. From the right of Biron, right out into the slot area, Tyler Kennedy. Forehand, backhand. And Marty Biron a little bit screened there. Got a couple of people in front of him. Can't move back quickly to get to Kennedy. And that's our Toyota turning point that made the score 2-0. But the Flyers have come back with one. And it is loud in here, guys.
No doubt about that. Flyers hoping there'll be another turning point in this game before it comes to its end. 5:46 away. This will be icing on the Penguins. Coburn is back for the touch-up.
Flyers have done so many things right in this hockey game.
Well, Arbeck's trying to stare down the referee, saying, guess what? I just took a stick in the mouth and you didn't catch it. And he tried to stay down on the ice to be able to bring a little bit more drama to it, but it didn't work out for him. Face-off comes to the right of Fleury with 5:43 remote.
Like Orpik's nose was kind of showing off the impact.
Thought it was evidence. Didn't work. Fedotenko moves the puck to center. And he catches up to it. Fedotenko to the back. Can't save Biron. Gathers and covers. Ruslan Fedotenko has had a lot of chances in this series. Not been able to get on the scoreboard. And here's what's at stake. Flyers, when they get a series even, Bill, not bad. 13 of 19 they've won, but when they trail 1-3, they have lost all 13 times. Penguins have been very good when up 3-1, and the NHL teams trailing 1-3 over the last three playoff seasons
26 times they've gone down 1-3 and they have lost all of them. Used to be that you'd see some comebacks, but for some reason here in recent years, these comebacks from down 2-0 and 3-1 in series have been few and far between. Flyers trying to avoid that situation with a comeback here. Lupo barreling it on the forecheck. Puck comes free. Lupo was grabbed by Eaton, but no call, and Crosby moves the other way. Crosby to the Philadelphia line, trying to flip it. Got that puck to Guerin, who swatted one wide. Jones.
That's the only rush in this game that Sidney Crosby has had speed between the blue lines.
Teaming in his pass off the stick of Carter into the Pittsburgh bench. Play stopped.
You know how the Flyers are going to play. They're going to throw everything but the kitchen sink as far as the forecheck's concerned. This is about how the Penguins are going to play. How they're going to be. Are they going to be aggressive? Are they going to sit back? Billy, right now, they've been very aggressive in the offensive zone.
Yeah, they have, Coatsy, but the Penguins have not been very good in this period. They've been that good in this game. All of the numbers so favor the Flyers. Without Marc-Andre Fleury, this game would be a runaway for Philadelphia.
Look out here, a backhander careens off a body to Kennedy. A stick goes flying. Parent without a stick. Kennedy dancing and shooting, and Albert's the block. But Albert's having to deal with Kennedy again, and he did. He got the puck to Briere, who looks for Giroux, but it hit something on the Philadelphia bench. Faceoff back into the Philadelphia zone.
But Coach, you're right. They're playing in the right end of the ice, the Penguins are, to try to protect the lead.
4:36 on the third period clock.
I think, like right there, you see Kennedy stall. They're all deep. A lot of teams, they wouldn't do that. They'd have one up and then have everybody back and waiting and trying to clog everything up here in the neutral zone, but they're going after it right now.
And they get to the loose puck here. Biron is knocked down as Talbot got right in on him. Now a turnover, Malkin to the puck. Getting Malkin. Around for Fedotenko. Carl overtakes him, flips it along, and the Flyers will look to move up. Knubel to Richards. Richards around one, lost control. Gagne will take a shot. That's blocked. Scuderi got in the way. And Malkin will get that barely out to center ice off of Gagne. Carl across ice. Return feed from Coleman, looks for Gagne, couldn't find him, no ice, and Fleury out. Fleury, that puck away, Carl, a good pinch, but Malkin takes it away, got it to Talbot. Back it goes, Carter, floating one, block, look out, no one back. Here's Kunitz, steamrolling in, here comes Coburn, Kunitz shot, save Vera! Mark it down, rebound shot, save Vera, another rebound, he's got it in the glove! Marty Vera keeps his team in the game.
What a magnificent job. That was the icing for the Penguins. If Marty Biron doesn't make not only the last save with the glove, but watch this poke check. Brayden Coburn didn't have him, so he went to the other side. Biron saw the opportunity to go for the poke check, and he nailed it.
Still one goal game because of that great effort. Penguins. See it now low. Flyers get to it. Maneuvering on up. Lupo. Looking feed for Hartnell. A shot and a stick save. Flurry into the safety netting. Flyers will get an offensive zone draw.
You know, on that play before, you got to give Coburn an awful lot of credit because here you got a situation where they could put the game away. But he stayed away from it. He let Marty make the save. Kunitz did a great job of protecting the puck away from Coburn. But the bottom line is that's one-on-one hockey. Coburn did not take a penalty. And still, now the Flyers still have the ability to be able to tie this hockey game. But Marty Biron with a great save. And then on the second opportunity was right there.
Draws to the right of Fleury. Giroux won it. Flyers get to it. Teeminen trying to get that puck, keeping one off the shin pad to the corner. Briere spinning it along, and he loses Carcillo. Gill chopped that by Giroux. Giroux gets it back. Sent it in front. Fleury had it hit him. Briere was there, and it bounced off of Fleury. Now here's Carcillo for Giroux. Giroux in on the left wing. Settles the puck down. His shot is blocked. Second try off the stick of Fleury to Carcillo. Carcillo centers. Never made it to Giroux. Jones will step up on the play. Around for Briere. Briere turning with it. Briere back out. Shot Teeminen. Hit a stick in front. Giroux, and Giroux is knocked down. And the Penguins move it ahead. 2:40 to play. Greg Adams with a pass. And that's tipped by Teeminen. Gathered by Jones ahead for Carcillo. He's by himself for now, so he'll just flutter it deep, head off on a change as the Flyers
Go after it. Carl gets to it. But a centering pass knocked down. Kept in by Richards. Richards to the corner. Knocked out. Centered. And it careens off the stick to the corner. Coburn in front. Canova looking for it. But Eaton was there instead. And Gonchar ices it. Carl back to get the whistle.
Flyers in full pinch mode. Everybody up on the play. Both defensemen. And Sergei Gonchar decided just to take the icing here. His guys will have to stay on the ice. I don't think anybody's called a timeout. Nobody's going to the benches. I know Philadelphia hasn't. And you wouldn't want to here either.
Richards and Staal. Staal won it. Faceoff's a benefactor in this series. That huge win by Staal, but the Penguins ice the puck again. Carl touches up. So with exactly 2 minutes remaining, the Flyers with another offensive zone draw. Can they find a way to win a big draw here? And Bausma looking out.
Boy, the fact that Sergei Gonchar iced the puck twice isn't an indication that the Penguins are hanging on for dear life here. I don't know what is.
And the Flyers had a chance at that puck off the draw, could not come up with it. Here's Coburn back. Pursued by Cook. Beats him. And Coburn speeds up to center ice. Coburn the right wing feed to Carter. Carter all the way in. Sent it back in front behind Flurry. No one there. Now it's centered. And Crosby got his glove on it. Great keep by Carl at the point. But no Flyers to pick it up. Gonchar is there. Got it as far as Coburn. And they say out to center and back in offside. 91 seconds is all that's left. The Flyers should try to send this to overtime.
What a great play by Braden Coburn moments ago, and Jeff Carter was looking for anybody in orange.
Boy, if you could get a break there, maybe go off of Gonchar, but Gonchar was paying attention to seeing where that puck was. But boy, what a great play by Carter to be able to hold on to it, draw Fleury way out, and then bring it back into the crease area.
Biron looking to the bench now as the Flyers get the puck deep to Pittsburgh ice, but he's staying on the ice for now. He's inching his way up, but still on the ice as Hartnell battles with Scuderi. He's knocked down by Scuderi. Scuderi still after it. Good work by Scuderi, and it bounces to center. Demon is going to rip it back in. Vera again toward the bench, but does not come off the ice.
Well, the Flyers were offside, and they didn't know it, so they blew it down. There was a delayed call waiting to happen.
And now Marty settles back in between the pipes with a neutral zone draw.
Timeout. It looks like John Stevens is going to call here.
That indeed is the call. So they gather. The respective benches with 68 seconds left in regulation. So much at stake here over the final minute plus of this third period. Stevens knocking out instructions.
Well, it's Craig Berube, the assistant coach, that's laying this play out. Now, obviously, they want to have a plan to be able to win that faceoff, get the puck deep, get as many people on that puck as possible, outnumber the Pittsburgh Penguins in their own zone, and simultaneously get Marty Biron out of the net.
A lot has to happen in a minute and 8 seconds. But it starts with winning the faceoff. You saw Craig Berube was diagramming stuff that happens in the offensive zone, not in the neutral zone. So everything's predicated on the Flyers getting this faceoff and getting the puck back in the offensive zone.
Got it forward. Couldn't control it.
Oh, here's
it flips
a break.
Up into the Pittsburgh bench off the Penguins. They get their offensive zone draw.
They do get it because the puck left the ice surface inside the Penguins' blue line. Faceoff has to come at one of the dots on the ice, and when it's inside that zone, it goes to this dot.
And so six Flyer skaters. And they win the draw. The point shot sails wide of heavy traffic. Teaming it in along. Hartnell after it. Richards there too, but Hartnell actually played it away from Richards. It's tipped ahead. Empty net drive for Talbot. He scores. The Penguins take a 3-1 lead with 51 seconds remaining. Talbot into the empty net. And they now 51.3 seconds away
from a 3-1 series lead, as well as this 3-1 lead in the game.
And the Flyers did what they wanted to do, win the draw in the offensive zone, got a shot, but it went wide, and they never were able to regain possession of it. Good work by the Penguins to chip it out, and as soon as Maxim Talbot got the red line, he let it rip, and Marty Giroux's gone to the bench again.
Tucked into the safety netting, so whistle. Faceoff will be in center ice this time. Giroux's going to come back out onto the ice.
Flyers have outshot the Penguins 44-26 in this game. They've clearly had the better of play. They've had a ton of power play chances, and yet they're not going to end up right end of the score from their perspective. Here is Coburn ahead, deep into the Pittsburgh zone. Giroux again goes to the bench. Flyers working that puck free. Backhander save Fleury, and he's able to cover up. Kadubel digging away in front after getting off that backhander, but Fleury, as he has done all game long, with the exception of that one shot by Carcillo, managed to make the save.
The only one he missed was the one that was unstoppable, the shot by Dan Carcillo. He has been the difference maker in this game. He will steal this game for the Penguins. By any statistical measure, by any territorial measure, use whatever yardstick you want, the Flyers deserve a better fate.
They're still trying to get another one past him here. Coburn floating one, but that's blocked aside. The other way, Talbot. That bounces to Craig Adams with the empty net, and Coburn comes back to knock it away from him. Coburn will set it to the wall. Just 10 seconds remain, so this series goes back to Pittsburgh for game five, and the Penguins will have an opportunity to close out the Flyers on Thursday night. 3-1 the final score. Marc-Andre Fleury with 45 saves. And no doubt about it, star of this hockey game. And the Penguins get their split in Philadelphia and take the 3-1 lead.
If the Flyers can muster the same kind of effort that they put forth tonight, they could just prolong this series in Pittsburgh, because they would force Marc-Andre Fleury to do what he did tonight again. That's really hard to do.
Tonight's Stanley Cup playoffs, game four, was brought to you by Chevy. Find your nearest dealer on ChevyDealer.com. And by Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you. Coming up after the post-game show, it's Toyota Sports Night. Let's get a preview by sending it down to the studios to Greg Murphy.
All right, thank you, JJ. Here's what's coming up after our Flyers coverage on Toyota Sports Night. Derek Dunn speaks to both parties regarding Sheldon Brown's request for a trade. You'll want to hear what he had to say, plus Joe Banner's response in an exclusive conversation. The Phillies finally get back on the field and try to focus on baseball. We have highlights and reaction from their game with the Brewers. Plus, D. Lineham has the latest on the Sixers as they get set for tomorrow's Game 2 in Orlando. All of that and more. But first, back upstairs to Jim Jackson and Bill Clement. Take it away, guys.
All right, Greg, thank you very much. 3-1. Those are the operative numbers. Final score of the game and now the series.
Yep, we'll take a look at our Comcast Business Class save of the game. The Flyers threatened so often in the third period, and there were many good chances, including this one. Off the backboards by Danny Briere, and Marc-Andre Fleury just kept inventing ways to stop pucks. Our Comcast Business Class save of the game.
He was at his athletic best in this one. Back to wrap it up in a moment.
Time for a Bud Light player of the game. Is there any doubt in a 45-save performance here in Game 4 at the Wachovia Center, Marc-Andre Fleury of the Pittsburgh Penguins? Grand theft. He earned the win by himself for the Penguins and by a landslide as our Bud Light player of the game.
Old saying that the goaltender can be the great equalizer in the sport of hockey. Marc-Andre Fleury was more than that here on this evening. Penguins get the win they coveted in Philadelphia and at home with a 3-1 lead in the series. Tonight's Flyers-Penguins Game 4 of the Eastern Conference Quarterfinals is brought to you by Toyota, a smart way to keep moving forward. By Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. And by Smooth Busch Beer and easy drinking Busch Light. No cliche here. It is must-win time for the Flyers. Game 5 of this series Thursday night at Mellon Arena in Pittsburgh. The Flyers win or their season comes to an end. If they do win, suddenly it's 3-2 and heading back to Philadelphia for Game 6. Flyers-Penguins, Game number 5 from Pittsburgh Thursday night, 7 o'clock. Right here on Comcast Sportsnet in high definition where available. And if there is a Game 6, of course, you can get ticket information. Also, reserve your 2009-2010 season tickets. Here's the number, 215-218-PUCK, or log on to the Flyers website. Coming up next, Dodge presents post-game live, complete analysis, press conferences, and more. They'll look at what was an entertaining game, but a frustrating one for the Flyers as they go down 3-1. For the entire crew, including executive producer and director Brian Cooper and associate producer Chris Majaro, and my partners Bill Clement and Steve Coates, I'm Jim Jackson. Good night from the Wachovia Center. Stay tuned now as Dodge presents Flyers Post Game Live.